once again, they're both on, and then what shall happen with those actions?
Will that be addressed?
I think that's to be addressed, though. That's an investigation, I think, the focus of this is whether or not the misapplication be played in. I appreciate the comments, but I think that's what's being addressed.
Right, I agree.
Until that takes place, I'll put up this misapplication.
May the coach make a quick statement? It's not an adversarial statement in relation to this matter.
I think at this time, we're in the motion to discuss.
Okay.
I would just like to echo something that, we're still in the investigation state on Coach Alexander and the rejection of whether or not there was two principals of our kind of flight, which is required for a rejection, whether it was one principal of our flight, which was not in the penalty.
I apologize. I thought I read he was ejected, Coach. I apologize. I thought it was ejected.
It's written, but it's something that we are, as you said, it started beginning. There's some things that we are working through. It's one of the incidents that we are working through. So I make sure that there was two principals on the flight. Well, if there wasn't, there was only one principal on the flight, and he wasn't ejected from the contest. So those are one of the things that we're working through. And Mr. Whaley, would that be effort?
That's correct. Mr. Snyder and I are still in communication as far as investigation is concerned. We have not. OSSAA is not. Mr. Snyder and I are still in communication in regard to all incidents that occurred post-game, and those things have yet to be determined, and any sanctions that are involved in that have yet to be determined. Until Oklahoma City would file a final report on that, those matters would still be considered to be under investigation.
Point well taken, Mr. Shakley. I appreciate that. I think it was not under investigation what Coach Alexander said today.
And he has admitted to that, and Oklahoma Public Schools has admitted that. They expand that.
So even if we just leave those comments, I'm not checking my stance.
Okay, just to clarify, any further discussion before we move on to that?
I mean, Tom Bunahan, board member, point of clarification on the motion. We have a motion that's going against our set rule policy, and a motion that, even though the NFHS says this does not apply to an individual situation, I don't understand how we think that.
I think whenever I look at it, I think it is an unusual situation. I disagree with the NHS, what they're saying, personally, my own personal opinion. The other thing is I think this is what is right for all kids. All kids. That's my first look at it.
Any discussion? Questions? Now, turn the motion, Mr. Hudson.
I make a motion this football game be played it over in its entirety.
With any stipulations?
I think that it would require further discussion. Mr. Stephen made, so he would second with
the exception.
Do what?
Add
a neutral side. That is something that has to be discussed among staff, the Oaks Grove, and Douglas. Obviously, it wouldn't be fair to make Locust Grove drive all the way back to Oklahoma City. Obviously, there were some problems with game management there as well. But I make a motion that this game be played over in its entirety.